home from the farm club meeting last night, and how did he put it exactly? We voted to sponsor the rodeo!
Fantastic! I can't believe it! I can't!
Right here in August, he said!
I gotta be dreaming! Lockjaw!
Ooh!
Lockjaw?
Yes, Wendy.
I, need two barrels.
Uh-huh. They voted in favor.
Please? We've been working for months. We'll be the most beautiful rodeo team ever.
Pull in your reins, little girl. You know your mama's against this.
Please, you can convince her. Now, she's having a little trouble cornering, freezing up and all.
Hey, Kick, if you were Wendy, wouldn't you want to tell your mother yourself?
But I can't. I don't know how. You know, Mom.
I've been worried about the back pasture ever since the storm last week. You best ride out and check it. I'll go into town and order up a few new rails.
All right, I'll check it first thing after supper. While you're there, get a couple of 4x4s for that old stable, okay?
All right.
Mom?
Are you going to open your present from Aunt Sally or not?
Oh, yeah.
Where's it from this time?
Harry.
Woo! She sure gets around, that sister of yours.
Oh, she's got a wonderful life. Never has to worry about a back pasture, that's for sure.
Look!
Oh, she sends you such beautiful things. Look at it, you old coyote. Maybe some culture will rub off. Right, Wendy?
Mom?
Oh, I almost forgot. She sent me a letter, too.
Yeah?
Mm-hmm. Told me all about Paris and enclosed this for your lessons.
Lessons?
Yes. I thought you should have some dance lessons this summer before you go into high school. And your aunt agrees.
Dancing lessons?
Now, listen just a minute. We're both concerned that living in the country and being on this ranch that you're going to miss out on certain refinements that you'll find important later on.
I'm not going to take any dumb dancing lessons.
Not even after Aunt Sally has agreed to pay for them?
How did she agree to pay for something I didn't agree to take? All I want to do this summer is work with Kick and enter in the rodeo in August.
I thought we had settled that.
I think I better go talk to the chickens.
No, Lockjaw. Please stay.
Why do you hate rodeo so much?
How can you ask that, Wendy? When your father traveled the circuit for I don't know how many summers. And look at Lockjaw, limping because of... I don't want to talk about it. And this is not the place. I just know that I do not want you to take up the rodeo ways.
Can I be excused?
No, you haven't eaten anything. And there's a special dessert.
I don't want any dessert. I don't want any dancing lessons. I don't want anything! First, I thought I was going to enter everything in the rodeo. But then I decided to drop goat tail racing in the trail course and just concentrate on barrel racing, breakaway cap roping, and pole bending. That'll still cost a fortune. There's a fee, you know, for every event. Well, my dad will pay for them, no sweat. How are you going to do it? Well, I only thought I'd try barrel racing. It's all I've ever wanted. It's still a lot. More than $25 for just one event. There's the entry fee and the hauling fee and the riding clothes. And you gotta get your mom to sign the medical statement. She's still giving you trouble?
Well, we're working it out.
Well, what if she doesn't give you the money?
I said we're working it out. She'll come around soon.
Well, you'd think so.
Yeah?
Sure, I mean, what with her being the rodeo champion and all. I'm kind of surprised you hadn't told me yourself, you know? Just last night, my mom was saying how nobody could beat your mom at barrel racing and how she went on to the big time and met your dad and...
Wendy? My mom was barrel racing champion?
Well, yeah. Didn't you know that?
Thanks for taking care of these cars for a couple of months.
Let's go.
I'm sorry we can't move the back of the
circus. Oh, that's okay.
Hey, help!
Come on, Buckley. That's it.
She's got a lot of spunk for an old pony.
Well, don't let her looks deceive you. She might look like an old mop, but she'll give you a run for your money. Come on.
Which horse did you barrel race on, Mom? Come in.
I really meant to tell you before this. I didn't want you to find out from someone else. I'm sorry. It's just that I knew that you'd say, if you were in the rodeo, then why can't I be?
Well, why can't I be?
Wendy, look at me. The rodeo led me here to this farm, and this is where I'm going to stay for the rest of my life.
What's the matter with the farm?
Well, it's not the farm exactly. It's just that I want more for you. I want you to see the world, travel to exotic places, like Aunt Sally. I want the world to be more than just a picture painted on a teacup.
Mama, please, just this once, let me barrel race.
I've been so set against this that it's almost impossible for me to say yes.
I promise I'll do all my chores. I'll go to dance class without complaining. I'll even pay all the rodeo fees if you'll just get me the barrels. They don't cost much, do they?
How are you going to pay for the rodeo fees?
Well, I've been saving my allowance, and I saved most of the Christmas money Aunt Sally gave me.
Well, I need more time to think about it. If I say yes, I'll ask Lockjaw to find three barrels, but you're going to have to pay for the rest of it yourself.
Side leg so he gets the idea to turn, that's it.
Okay, now pull his nose to the right with the right hand rein, that's it. Now faster.
Move!
Be the boss, Wendy.
He always does this. The barrels don't make any better at all.
I guess Kick figures a short lesson will be enough for today. Hey, buckwheat! So, looks like you want to study barrel racing, too, hey, old buckwheat?
It's just one more thing not going right. Well, I'm sorry, but Mr. Carter said he just doesn't need anyone to work in the evenings. Did you tell him it was the only time I could get free? That I got school and chores and rodeo practice otherwise? Of course. Look, why don't you just tell your mom the truth? That you spent all your allowance and birthday money on the 4-H fair, and maybe she'll help you. You don't know my mom.
Come on, get in there.
Wendy, the Benchley car is here.
Yes, Mom, coming.
You don't want to make everybody else late for dance class. Mm-hmm.
What's all that stuff?
Oh, it's just... Mom, I was going to go into town.
You better get going. Dance well.
Yes. This is Helen Hurstead. Hello? Sally? Where are you? Oh, really, you are? Oh, you nut. Oh, wait a minute. Wendy? Oh, you just missed her. Oh, she's going to be so excited you're coming. Well, of course. 245, flight 10. Oh, I can't wait to see you. I'll leave in a minute. Sooner. Bye-bye.
How about $6 for this one?
Okay.
And $4 for the duck.
Six?
$4.50.
I've got to have at least five.
All right, five. And $2 for each of the spoons.
Three?
$2.50.
Okay. How about $5 for this?
Oh, that's so beautiful. Are you sure you want to leave everything?
I've got to.
Really? Why?
I've just got to. Please give me the money.
Well, I'll try my best not to sell a thing. Sound fair? I'll give you every chance to buy everything back. And here's an extra five.
Really? Thanks. You know, I think everything's going to finally work out now. As a matter of fact, I'm sure of it. Thanks again. Bye.
Bye.
Singapore must have been wonderful.
Oh, yeah. You see a lot of it locked in a hotel room for 2 weeks. I told you, the whole trip was nothing but one long meeting in different conference rooms around the world.
Oh, I'd take a hotel room and a conference then and again. Anything to get away from this blasted pickup truck. I'm sorry about the tire.
Oh, are you kidding? This is the best time I've had in months. If I'd have been smarter, I'd have never left here.
You're crazy. Who's got the best job in the world?
You do. The horses, the country air, and Wendy. I'll tell you what. I will give you 6 months in fancy hotels for just 2 weeks at your ranch.
It's a deal.
How is Wendy, by the way?
Oh, don't get me into that problem. She's driving me nuts about a silly rodeo. She's probably out practicing right now. Oh, blast this nugget. Lug nugget or whatever they call it.
Don't stop here. Go around it. Blast you, kid. Come on, move. Oh, kid, go. Come on. Stop being so stubborn.
Wendy, come down. You're upset. When are you gonna see? Kick isn't gonna do it just yet.
He is.
He isn't. You can't make him do something he doesn't want to do. I'm sure you'd agree with me on that one, wouldn't you, Kick? Yeah, I bet you would, boy.
I don't know what I'm gonna do. You're a nice old girl, but good for absolutely nothing.
I wonder what she'd be like to ride, huh?
She'd probably fall over, judging by her looks. You think Kick would get jealous if I took her for a spin? Let's see. Oh, Buckwheat, you're so beautiful. And you've got such beautiful legs. I bet you'd be so much prettier and faster than Kick going around the barrels. And you're so much taller. And what big, long ears you have. She called from the airport when you were out.
Hi, ma'am.
Aunt Sally, it's wonderful to see you.
You okay?
Yeah, I think I'll go wash up.
And now, oh, for these presents I have lugged halfway around the world. I'm beginning to feel silly giving you all those little girl presents when you've gotten so big. Here's something I couldn't resist.
Aunt Sally, I've loved everything you've given me, but this is the best.
It's to round out your collection.
Oh, Wendy, it's for your spoons. Oh, it's beautiful, Sally. Go get your spoons and put them in right now so we can see what it looks like.
Oh, no. Oh, no!
Wendy, what is it?
Why did you have to come now? I was gonna get everything back, honest, but I didn't have a choice. I'm sorry.
What on earth?
I needed money for the rodeo. I tried to get a job, but nobody would hire me. So I took everything Aunt Sally gave me.
You told me you saved your money from the allowance.
It was to a very nice lady. She said she'd try not to sell them. I can buy them back.
You sold Aunt Sally's gifts to get into that rodeo?
Helen, wait a second.
Sally, keep out of this. I've tried to make you see that there are more important things in this stupid rodeo, and you turn around and sell Aunt Sally.
Aunt Sally, I loved everything you've given me. I really have.
Of course you love them, and I can't think of any better use for them than to finance your career. Cheer up. I'll go back down to the store and buy the things back, and then you'll have
no. No, that's too easy. Sally, she lied to me.
Mama, please, I know what I did wrong. I promise I'll never lie to you again. I'll get the gifts back and everything. They were mine to sell.
That's true, Helen.
Yes, but the lie still holds. I absolutely will not sign that medical release for the rodeo.
No!
Now, wait a minute. Didn't I give her the gifts in the first place?
I don't want to discuss it. I've made my decision.
Please, you can't keep me out of the rodeo.
I'm sorry I brought you into this, Sally.
Haven't you ever wanted anything this much, Mom?
The subject is closed, Wendy.
I think you're making a mistake.
No. If she starts riding in the rodeo, she's going to end up just like me.
What is so terrible about that?
I want her to do something more with her life. You certainly have.
Well, so have you. Oh, my heavens, look at this place. It is wonderful. And so is Wendy. She's a super kid. I can't imagine why you want to change her. Let her ride in the rodeo.
can't. And I'm tired of talking about it. Now let's go to bed.
Good night, Sally. Sleep well.
I'm not staying here anymore.
Where are you going?
Away.
Well, I should know where to send the mail.
Lockjaw. I can't even run away right. What am I gonna do?
So what's ailing you, huh?
Everything. She doesn't listen to me. She doesn't care about me. All she wants is for me to be like Aunt Sally, but I'm not Aunt Sally.
So you're planning to run away and ride Kick in the rodeo anyway?
You know I am.
Even if he's not a barrel horse and never will be.
But he is, you'll see. Even if it isn't in him, I'll make him a barrel horse.
Hector, you're the lucky one. You get to be yourself. Just a ragged old chicken chaser. Nobody's trying to change you into something you're not.
What are you saying?
You know how you feel about your mom forcing you to take those dance classes.
I hate it.
Well, that's how Kick feels about you pushing him to race barrels. He ain't the best horse for it.
So what am I supposed to do?
Well, if you really love Kick, you let him be himself. A beautiful gelding who likes to amble through life at his own pace. He's no athlete, but he's still the best pleasure horse around.
Pleasure horse.
And your best friend.
So I give up now, right? And quit trying to be in the rodeo?
Maybe. Maybe not. Pick up that saddle over there if it's all right with you and follow me.
Here is pretty, ain't it? Sun sneaking up. Little piece of pale moon over there. Makes you think a little about things bigger than just you and me. Morning, Babs. Sleep all right? That's good. Okay. I'm gonna want you to heave-ho that saddle up right over here.
Buckwheat?
Uh-huh.
Are you kidding me?
Nope. And I'm gonna want you to take this old pony down to those barrels yonder.
I'm not doing anything! Wow!
That's right!
I can't even stop him! He's big! He's a real barrel!
Let him do it himself! Yes, now with your right hand!
Look! What's going on out here? Come on, he won't stop! Come on!
Everything all right?
Let her
rip! That's right! That's great! That's great, Wendy! Lean to the right, Wendy! Lean to the right!
What are they doing?
They're running the barrel race paddock. And they're good. Ricky never told us that was a barrel horse he was giving us. His sister must have rode it. 22 seconds. Not bad for the first time.
We could bring that time down plenty in 2 weeks left before the rodeo. Why, she could do half decent on that old nag. You do.
It was better to let him be himself. You know what I mean?
No. But, good luck anyway.
Gee, you think I'm gonna make a fool out of myself?
Well, the way I...
Wendy?
See it
is... There you are.
Mom!
I got something for you. It's my old rodeo shirt. It's probably too big.
It's beautiful.
It's just a shirt.
Mom? I love you.
I love you, too, with all my heart.
The winner and new champion of breakaway calf roping is Janet Benchley. Let's give her
Janet
a hand,
won. I hope I don't make a fool out of myself.
Now, you'll do just fine. Remember, winning isn't everything. And riding in the rodeo isn't either. Maybe that's a lesson you'll learn today. And it's a good, important lesson, Wendy. I love you. Okay?
Okay.
The next event is barrel racing. Will all contestants please get ready?
Oh, no.
Good luck.
Just keep a light hand and have her moves match yours. Remember what we've been saying. Let Bucky have her own way.
Tammy Tiller, number 26. There you go. There she's in the crowd. That's a good start.
Show your stuff. Go!
And there goes Wendy.